Assalamu alaikum viewers, I hope that you all are good and saving yourselves from the from affected and staying home, and I believe that you can be stay safe. In the series of lectures for introduction to mass communication, media studies BS 2K19 and English BS 2K19 as well. Today, on which topic we are going to discuss, which is the history and development of communication in the field of mass media. As we know, the communication, which is the first achievement of a human, that human was first able to talk, and this achievement is unique and it gave us a quite different from the animals, that we are able to think, we are able to talk, we are able to respond. How this communication has take a part in the development? So there are the some ages which are consist of 6 to 7 ages of communication development. One by one we will discuss mainly over all these. Before discussing the all, I want to tell you about the communication, about the communications history and their ages. The ages of communication is, the ages of communication are these: pre-Stone Age, number second age of speaking, number third age of reading and writing, number fourth age of printing, number five age of radio, TV, and number 6 age of ICT, and number 7 age of post ICT era. So imagine that you are one person and is the evolution theory of Islam and evolution theory of West, those who did not believe in the existence of God. Both have the two approaches, two dimensions of view the history, and both are quite different to each other. That persons who believe that this world was came into being through the big explosion, and it is totally based on the matter mass, they have an other approaches regarding communication development. And those who believe any kind of religion, they have also the believe that the communication, the speaking power was given by Almighty Allah to Hazrat Adam. Hazrat Adam, in our simple language, in English and literary one, who use it in another way. So the evolution of earth from the both kind, that both are have the different views, different point of view, different approaches regarding the evolution of world. Similarly, both ideologies, both have different perspective of observation regarding the development of communication as well. The development of communication was developed itself as people did not speak, but before that they use the signs and signals. The use of signs and signals before producing the word, it is also considered as a language, and most of language, which are the oldest language, which on its importance, which got its clearly understanding, even yet in this era. These are the nonverbal communications. The nonverbal communication has importance after the verbal communication as well. It is helpful to convey our message to the large number of people. So in the age of stone, the people were not enabled to speak and talk, but in communication development, the age of speaking was considered as the first human's achievement. Was speaking, was communicating, was talking to each other as a verbal communicating. Before that, the people used to talk through the signs and signals as well. But it was the first achievement that people were able to talk, and in this era, the evolution of agriculture era was take a first evolution of its development as well. Agriculture era and age of speaking have a resemblance to each other. So after the speaking, the second age was started, the reading and writing. People speak that word, but the language, the concept of language was not famous. The people can be produce a word, but they have no any idea how to write it. After that, the alphabetic concept was created, the concept of language came into being. According to historian, these two language was the oldest language of the word, which is Chinese and Mayans. The both languages had set the alphabets, and people were able to write and read. Those words was produced by the people. Now they are able to talk, able to write these words, and other can be produce these words. So this age was known as the agriculture age, and people have interact and exchange the agriculture productions each other, because at the time the language is also developed itself as well. So after that, the age of printing, which was a word is going to be too much big, too much people were migrating from one place to another place, and interaction between the peoples was came into being as well. So the age of printing was the 14th century, and people before the printing are able to write and read the books by hands, and that was a tedious process, that was a too much time consuming process. So the printing bring the revolution in the field of mass communication, and communication develop itself first time develop itself after the printing press, and it was the first achievement. I believe that the foundation of mass communication department come true by the help of invention of printing press. After the printing press, we were entered into the era of industrialize. Some machineries replaced the humans, and those work was done by the human, 100 humans, that machine worked lonely. It was the big revolution across the globe, and people were tried to take SMEs, tried to founded SMEs and big industries across the globe, and the basic evolutions of urban society was emerged after the agriculture society. This was also a foundation of urban society, that people do work and sell the product by the help of some kind of machineries, and the printing press is also as a tool, as a machine, as a vehicle of communication, which bring the revolution in the field of miscommunication. After age of printing, the communication developed itself as a age of visual communication. The first, after the printing press, newspaper and magazines, in 19th century, the first time radio was invented by Marconi, and BBC, British Broadcasting Corporation, was the oldest form of communication, as a visual communication, that we can be record a sound, and that particular record of a sound can be disseminated, can be shared, can be listened by a large number of people. This was another big achievement in the field of mass communication after the printing press. So it was only we can listen the voice of what we cannot see. That after the television, the J. Lord Barnard and his physicians team also bring a revolution across the globe. It was not the gap of century. The radio and TV was invented in the same century. The radio was invented in 1922, and television was invented in 1937. So radio and television was bring a revolution in the field of mass communication, and people were able to understand the society, its development, and learn about the different cultures, learn about the different languages, and it was a globally reformation, globally change, which proved human is civilized and human is sometimes uncivilized, and people have designed some kind of procedure how to communicate in an international society. So in USA and other developed countries, the television is the part of their family member. They treat television as a family member and they learn from the television. That was a big difference between the our society and other society. So now after the age of radio and television, we were entered in the 90s. 90s era in 1999 and early 21st century. The 21st century, which is known as the century of digital media, digitalize everything, and I am the eyewitness of that age. The inspection of that age, we were a child, but after that, this age bring many kind of changes and speedily change the setups, change the all these things which are only a thinking, only a desire, only a dream that it can be a possible. That finish the distance, it close the distance, that people can be sit, people can be lived throughout the world in any place from where they can be talk to each other, they can be now see the each other, they can now watch to each other, they can physically check, physically see, physically observe the position of a person. This was too much changes in the age of ICT, information communication and technology. Information communication and technology bring the revolution more than the television and radio TV, because all these mode of communication have converted it, itself as a from hard to soft. And in this age of information communication and technology or digital era, people are able to communicate easily. And social media, which was a part of this era, which bring the many kind of revolution, the every movement, every designed strategy, designed movement, political, ethical, social, human activist, all these kind of movements which are continuously doing work for the betterment of societies are exist on the social world. The social media world and the social society has developed itself in the age of ICT, which was a uniqueness of our society. But people, those who were doing their communication in a limited circle, and the messages, the problems was in a limited circle, but it was also bring changed that after the ICT and modern world, these minor problems become the major problems, and the even the those same problems which were discussed in little group of people, and now due to the social media, YouTube, WhatsApp, Twitter, these issues are discussed on as a worldwide. So this was a change. Now, after the post era of ICT, what will be the world? It is based on the assumption, not as a experience and the reality. The some researchers, some mass communicators believe that the language will be changed, and people will be able to understand all kind of languages through the technological changes. In United Nations organization, I have also perceived and observed the everyone who can be talking their native language, the it was directly converted due to the technological invention into their local languages, and people are easy to understand. So post ICT era, which is also too much impressive, inspired as compared to the previous era. So this lecture was based on the history and development of communication is going to end. If you have any query or question, you may ask from me through WhatsApp, YouTube, or comment on anywhere. So after watching this video, you must be subscribe it and click the icon button. Thank you very much for watching.